I know the American stock market is wondering where did all the Model 3 sales go? Well, we do know that they are going to Europe and China. That's where they're going to be selling them in February. They've already been taking reservations, and now there is some more news, some more numbers, some exciting, some are not so exciting. I'll tell you what they are, and I'll tell you what they really mean, and if the demand is as big in Europe now in China as it is in the United States. All of that is coming up next. Welcome to E4 Electric, your number one source of unbiased electric car news. If this is your first time here, welcome. You definitely came to the right place. This year is going to be amazing for electric cars, for Tesla, and everybody else who's interested in this technology. Go ahead and click on the subscribe button so you don't miss any of this moving forward. And let's talk about Tesla Model 3. Now, the sales in the US are obviously going to drop. I already told you about my frustration with the stock market reacting so weirdly to that, like they didn't know and it just hit them all of a sudden. Tesla did slash prices by $2,000 for all three of their models to kind of help to ease the pain of not having the entire $7,500 tax credit, and now it's been cut in half. GM is next, by the way, starting in April. But these cars, and Tesla timed it perfectly, are now going to Europe and China. Now, it looks from early reports from the shipping companies are reporting, there will be about 3,000, at least the expectation is 3,000 of Model 3s coming to Europe every week. We're not sure about the numbers in China yet, and obviously the tariff there just gotten it got eased up, I think back to 25%, which is still a lot and tough to compete. But nevertheless, the reservations are holding pretty strong. But the numbers that they're releasing now, and this is through some of the sources, I would say a little bit concerning. So let's do the math together and let's see if it matches up with what's been happening in the US. Before that, of course, I want to remind you guys that this show and this channel is sponsored by XRAC, the accessories for those cars that cannot or you don't want to put cargo products on top on the roof of your car, like Model X with the wing doors open up, and it's essentially a roof rack for your vehicle hitch. As you can see from the pictures, a pretty cool solution. There's a discount code in the description of this video that will also get you free shipping. Check it out. Check them out at xrec.us. The link is also in the description. All right. So the Tesla Twitter account, not Elon Musk, the Tesla's Twitter account actually tweeted out saying that Model 3 configurator is now open to left-hand drive countries in Europe. Design your Model 3. All right. So first of all, left-hand drive, Britain, a few other countries. I think you guys are going to have to wait until closer to summer. They haven't really given us a date yet, as they normally do. And then when they do give us the date, is it really a date? But they're opening this to non-configuration holders. And let me be very clear. They've opened the allowed orders for reservation holders. You could configure the cars, but now they're opening it to anybody else, and they did this in the United States and Canada, but it took a while for the reservation holders to actually kind of empty that tank, if you will, or battery. But now it's only taken a month in Europe, and I don't know if this is a concern, because I mean there's also China, right? And they're still going to be selling it in the United States, and they're only making them at what, 7,000 of them per week tops. Now, there are, where are my numbers, 14,000 reservations have been already made. Now, granted, they're also now selling, not also, they're only selling now the performance and dual motor versions, just like they were in the United States. So these are the most expensive ones. So 14,000 of reservation holders actually configuring an order is pretty good. But really, they're going to burn through it in about a month, and maybe 5 weeks, right? And then what? Even if they order the middle range by then, that's going to be a pretty quick burn through the reservation holders compared to what happened in the United States. But if you remember, and I think this is the most mind-blowing number that they had from their delivery reports from the Q4, is that 3/4 of the Model 3s that were sold in the United States and Canada were not reservation holders. This is just people kind of getting in the last second and taking advantage of it. Now, even if we take, so let's say that's the same rate that they're going to be selling them at Europe in terms of how many non-reservation holders are going to jump on this. Even with that, if my math is correct, they will have about 4+ months worth of sales of these two top of the line, most expensive versions of the Model 3 in Europe. And then again, they better either start releasing the cheaper versions, the mid-range version, or maybe even by then they will start allowing the 35,000 version, if it's there by then, people to configure those. Now, of course, there's still, you know, we don't know what's going to be happening with sales in China. I'm assuming that will be a very popular car as well. Don't forget, you know, they were selling Model S and Model X in like ridiculous numbers in China with the ridiculous 25% tariff there. So, you know, Model 3, which is a cheaper version, yet some people really, really like them better than Model S and Model X, should do very well. So good start, good numbers, obviously solid numbers. How long it's going to be able to last, we don't know. We don't know when the sales of Model 3 are going to pick up in the United States. We don't even know what they are yet. I mean, we just know that they're going to be probably low. But that's okay. I mean, so far, I think this is a good start. Let me know in the comment section whether or not you're concerned with this numbers. Only 14,000 reservation holders in Europe configured the car, placed their orders. By the way, really quickly, let me give a shout out to one of my new Patreons, Mark Taylor. Thank you so much for joining my Patreon community. Of course, one of the biggest perks there, you can watch me live. And thank you for contributing to a full-time independent YouTuber like myself. I really do appreciate it. The link is in the description of this video if you want to join, but it's patreon.com/e4electric. All right, guys, let me know what you think. I'm cautiously optimistic. You know, 2019 is going to be great for Tesla and Model 3 and all electric cars. So I'm looking forward to it. Other than that, see you guys next time. And remember to stay charged.